Hi, I'm Lisa, a PhD student in the Computational Biology Department here at UNIL, and today I'll be talking to you about causal inference. Let's go. Here's a fun fact. All of us, without knowing it, are involved in the biggest human experiment in the world from the moment we're born. How? I'll get there in a second, but first let me tell you about randomized control trials. Scientists have been trying to figure out the causes of our diseases from a very long time. If they can figure out the causes of these diseases, they can work on stopping them and preventing the disease from occurring in the first place. Cool, right? They started out by investigating potential causes of diseases by selecting two random groups of people, keeping everything similar between these two groups, but allowing one group to partake in the potential cause and preventing the other group from it. They monitored these two groups over a long period of time and measured any potential difference in the development of disease between them. If there's a difference, then they know the cause. These randomized control trials were successful. However, they were also time-consuming, expensive, and morally unethical. The solution? Mendelian randomization. Remember that big experiment I was telling you about that we're all a part of? Well, it's true. Our genetics are randomly distributed at birth from our mother and father. And as a population, we make the biggest randomized control trial without actually knowing it. For example, some people have a variant of the gene that makes them sensitive to the effects of alcohol, so they tend to drink less in comparison with the rest of the population that have the other variant. We now have two naturally formed different groups with a measured difference in a potential cause: alcohol drinking throughout their lifetime. You can measure at one point the possible diseases that these two groups have, high blood pressure, cholesterol, heart problems, and determine if drinking alcohol causes these diseases, and if so, with what odds. So, Mendelian randomization uses our genetics to estimate the causal effect of potential risk factors on complex diseases. It has several assumptions that need to be true for it to be accurate, but this might not always be the case. This is what I'm working on for my PhD, trying to find a more robust method for assumption violations. Well, me and several others around the world. But at the bottom of it all, someday we'll understand our genetics well enough to prevent disease from occurring in the first place by being wise about what we do, eat, drink, or don't. Until then, thanks for being a part of the biggest human experiment on the planet.